This year is unique in that we have the COVID pandemic going on, and it is going to put stress on our healthcare system. So the flu shot is important for protecting the individuals who get the flu shot, making sure their illnesses are either prevented or milder, preventing them from needing to go to hospital, and preventing death as well, so that there's less strain on the healthcare system this year. If you're following the news, there's certainly parts of the world where seasonal influenza is less than it has been in previous years, in part due to masks, hand hygiene, and physical distancing. But this is a virus that circulates every year, and we do expect it to circulate this year, even if it's in less quantities. And so it can circulate at the same time that COVID-19 is circulating.
Yes, you can get both influenza and COVID-19 at the same time. There are a few patients that do get this, although it's very rare to happen. The symptoms are very similar between the two, so it's very hard to distinguish both of them, especially when they occur together. But it's much more common to have one or the other rather than both.
COVID-19 is caused by a different virus. It's called SARS-CoV-2. This is a different virus from the influenza virus. So when you get the flu shot, no, it does not protect you against COVID-19. And so far, we do not have any evidence to suggest that getting the annual flu shot would increase your risk of COVID-19 or more severe outcomes from COVID-19.
So we know that physical distancing, hand washing, staying home when sick certainly will reduce the flu spreading in the community, and we saw that last year. But we know that it's not perfect, as we're back together and at schools and in workplaces. There's still a risk of transmitting the flu even in the context of physical distancing and masking. And so it's important to get the flu shot to prevent both influenza transmission as well as people having symptoms in the community then needing testing and assessment.
We have a lot of data to show us that the flu shot is safe for groups like young children and those who are pregnant. And in fact, these are groups of the population who can have more serious consequences when they get the flu. And therefore, these are groups of the population that we highly recommend getting the flu shot every year.
So there are very subtle differences between all three, although for the most part they do mimic each other to the point where even a skilled doctor or nurse would not be able to tell the difference. The cold, you may sneeze a little bit more. With COVID-19, the loss of sense of smell may be a symptom. But there are a lot of symptoms like muscle pains, headaches, fevers, which really go with one or two of those. And so they're very hard to distinguish. They do slightly different things, but at the end of the day, people presenting with some of those symptoms, it's going to be difficult to tell the difference between the three, and therefore those people need to be tested to distinguish whether or not it's COVID-19. So preventing the spread of the flu is very similar to preventing the spread of COVID-19. Number one is good hand hygiene, preventing ourselves from touching objects or touching other people where we may touch our eyes, nose, and mouth and introduce the virus to ourselves. Number two is preventing while going out while sick, because that prevents us from spreading the infection to other people. The use of masks in indoor settings prevents our respiratory droplets going on other people. And finally, getting the flu shot, which is the big difference between the two. So we know that people who get the influenza vaccine, about 60% of them don't get influenza. And even the people that do get influenza often have a much milder disease when they get the flu shot.
If you have new symptoms or you're concerned you have the flu or COVID, it's important, because you have symptoms, that you stay home so that you protect those around you and those in the community. It's also advisable to get in contact with your primary care provider if you have access to one, because they can help guide you in terms of whether you should go to an assessment center for COVID testing or whether you might need more of an assessment at either urgent care or the emergency department.
So influenza vaccination and what will become of COVID-19 vaccination are very different. The proteins that we use to make an immune response to the influenza vaccine are going to be very different from COVID-19 vaccine, as they're completely different viruses. So there's no safety issues with getting your influenza vaccination this year. And if we do get a COVID-19 vaccination later in the year or next year, you can still get that as part of your normal day-to-day routine.
So the criteria for getting tested for COVID-19 is changing as we learn more about this pandemic and more about the symptoms that cause it. Currently, if you have symptoms such as fever, respiratory symptoms, new gastrointestinal symptoms, it is being recommended that you go get tested for COVID-19. So for those who don't have symptoms or who are asymptomatic, currently the recommendations are to only get tested if you have been in contact with someone who has COVID-19, or if you carry the COVID alert app and you've been alerted to the fact that you've been in contact with someone with COVID-19.